The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And a little delayed opening out here, still having a few technical issues from a direct lightning strike to the White House. So we'll move it along. Like to see everybody here bright and shiny. Of course, another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour with me, your humble, lovable, and squeezably soft host. Once more into the breach do we go, dear friends, and as always, we like to come off and start at this time of day.
Oh!
Oh, well. Nothing's going to work great today, but what else can you say? I was up at 4 o'clock this morning trying to get all of the software reinstalled on two new hard drives, and got most everything done today, but that's about it. We'll be back at 100% on Monday. We'll move along. Anyway, what else do we have happening on the show today? Well, you know, we've got a market, if you listened to my show yesterday, that I thought was going to be a little down. I thought maybe down as many as 10 points. We got to down 24.65. Could we kind of slide into the close? I think we could again today. But, again, one of these things where you have to kind of look at this being options expiration. There wasn't a lot of upside to be had, wasn't a lot of downside to be had. Spent a lot of time last night looking for option positions that may have moved today. I couldn't find anything that really looked like it was going to move rather largely into something you could play options on into expiration on the close. So a kind of a deal or a day out here where we're not going to get a lot of action today. We've got options rollover on Monday and Tuesday, so we're probably not going to see any real market direction till Wednesday. That takes us into fund buying time. And why there isn't a lot of upside in most stocks, my guess is that they will hold this market up at least through the end of the month buying pattern. So that actually, we're back on the 24th. You really get into it coming back on the Monday of the 31st of July. So next week could be another week of treading water. I don't see any patterns that really look like this thing's going to break out or go under. But it does look okay, so we'll keep an eye on that. Other things of interest for us today are, of course, getting through this day and trying to see how earnings turned out. So we'll look at some of that. We've got, of course, a big presentation coming out a week, actually next Wednesday. And that is going to be on, of course, going to be on machine learning. I've got kind of a little taster in the Tech Insider today on what we're going to be looking at. But again, not a lot. Was hoping we might get some pin action today on the Baker Hughes numbers for the rig count. Not finding a bottom quite yet in oil off a buck. Of course, gold's up $9.30 back at $12.54.80. And got a nice little pattern starting to develop here, which is a few dollars up every day on average. So we'll see how that works out. What else do we have? That's kind of it. So where I'm normally doing history and that kind of stuff, maybe we'll do that in the next segment if I can get everything wired up. That it. I got a few emails. You can always email me at path@tfnn.com if there's something you want me to bring up today. We also have a phone, if you remember what one of those things are, 877-927-6648. We also, of course, have email at path@tfnn.com. And if you're so lucky to be in the den, you can put something in there. So what else do we have going on today? Well, we'll keep an eye on it, but for the most part, it's time to get started here. Wanted to look at a couple of stocks with earnings, so we'll talk about that. But, probably the big mover out here that I think that is important for the broad markets is Cintas. These folks are the people that rent uniforms to many companies. They pick them up, they wash them, they return them, they do all that kind of work. So if they're doing good, that's generally a good sign for the broad markets in that more people are being hired to do jobs that require you to have a uniform on. Well, Cintas came out with earnings, very good, huge sign of strength today, decent breakout on volume. You needed 1.4 million shares, you got 1.6 million shares already, so figure this thing goes to 2 million shares today, spiked to 139.36. But a good sign for the general Main Street economy, maybe not so much for the Wall Street economy, but it looks fairly interesting. Listened to the Microsoft's earnings call last night, and as my theory had been that we were looking at some of these stocks that literally were priced for perfection. This thing was up to $76 after hours last night. It's down around 73 now. But it never really had the juice that you would like to see. We were looking for 35 million shares. A couple of days ago, we had 22. Yesterday, we had 42. So we had enough if it would have held up there, but a little kind of what they call gravestone doji out here, hanging man. And now just the opposite today. So we'll see what happens on Monday, but thought things were just about as good as they could get, and that's the problem, is there's not much upside when it's all front run into the earnings, and I think we've gotten that with many of these stocks, so we'll keep an eye on that. We'll do that. Anyway, we'll be back in a minute.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software.
software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Hey,
take your phone calls
now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
And we're back. We've got John in Philly on the lines. We're going to go right to him. He always has pithy questions. Give me a full report, John.
David, I wanted to ask you, please, about Bitcoin.
Okay.
Back in 2013, you provided an excellent service of going through, this was the fall of 13 as Bitcoin was running up to 1,100, where you talked about what blockchain technology is, what the Bitcoin item was, the Bitcoin mining process via, computers. So you went through all that, and we all can see what Bitcoin price-wise is doing. My question to you is, as you followed and tracked this, do you have a conclusion you can share with us, your listeners, regarding this topic? Will Bitcoin, will that particular blockchain technology, digital currency, will that continue to exist the next couple of years? Will it be continue to be supply constrained, or no to either of those questions?
I am just surprised the government hasn't already yanked, at least in the U.S., the ability to use it. 80% of all the money that is actually transferred is used for illegal activities. So the only thing you can figure out from that is that eventually the U.S. government will figure out a way to kill it, at least in the United States. So as a money source, I don't see it going very far. I'm always surprised every day that I get up and there's not an article that says that, that the IRS has decided to charge everybody 100% of whatever their account is in bitcoins and just wipe it out, or some other kind of way of, something the government does not like. But I think yesterday you brought up in the Tiger's Den that the successor to the Silk Road dark web website, which had another name. I forget the name of it now. But
Alpha Bay.
Yeah, there's been three others like that. So I can't even remember the names anymore. One pops up, they close it down. Another one pops up like this Alpha Bay. It gets shut down. But the technology behind Bitcoin is the blockchain, and I think that's what is valuable. I think that eventually the government's just going to get tired of seeing that Bitcoin is nothing but a way to ship drugs, sell humans, and sell illegal weapons. And that's 95% of the business, 80% of it being drugs.
Right.
Fentanyl, one of the biggest sellers, by some accounts, 50% of the sales on some on these dark websites. If you aren't familiar with fentanyl, it is a kind of synthetic version of heroin. It's 10 times more potent, and that's why everybody's dying in droves, because they mix it up with regular heroin, get 10 times as much, and they end up ODing. So there's a horrible, horrible bathtub ring for all the stuff that's happening in these financial backwaters and Bitcoin. And that always makes me worried. From snatching gold in the 30s, governments have a long history of making sure that you can't use these kind of things for very long. And I'm just surprised they, you know, are still allowing it.
But, gotcha. Well, thanks for answering that question. Just a follow-up to that, one notable Wall Street executive, her name is Masters. She used to be a J.P. Morgan executive, went and launched a firm several years ago to develop blockchain technology applications to be applied to securities markets, clearing activities, banking, what have you. And they rolled out a couple of what I'd call prototype systems on exchanges like down in Australia, for example. My question to you is, do you know of more of that sort of application to legitimate financial activities coming very soon?
I would say next 2 years. I've read a great many articles about what they're doing. For those people who don't understand what blockchain technology is, it's kind of a way to have one set of books that everybody has to agree on. If not everybody agrees on, then nothing goes through. So basically, if I was selling something to you, we both have to agree. After the exchange happens, we both have to say that they went through okay, and there's no problem with the transaction. And then, of course, it's finally done. But since we two are not the only people that have a set of those books, everybody that's in the same system will have that same set of books, then there's no way for anybody to come up with any hijinks. Kind of eliminates a huge amount of fraud. Wall Street is of two minds on this. One, they like it because they can get rid of all those clearinghouses for equities.
Right.
And then they hate it because then they can't nakedly short stocks, because they instantly would get their hands caught in the cookie jar.
Right, right, right. The other part of the double-edged sword, of course, is the transaction fees associated with are incredibly much lower, and hence the profit margin would be lower.
Yeah, they probably have somewhere between 5 and 7% of their net incomes taken away by clearinghouses and back-ends and just all the other stuff. They should be able to go through. I think that there's kind of the same kind of problem that they had in the 20s and 30s when computers and punch cards were really starting to come in. Wall Street, for a lot of people don't know, you could wake up in the morning on a Wednesday or a Friday in the 20s, and the stock market was closed. Wasn't closed for any bad reasons. Literally, they couldn't keep up with the exchange and getting all the shares moved and everything else. So it wasn't uncommon to see the stock market closed one day a week. At one time, they closed the stock market for an entire week just to catch up. And the thought is that all this exchanging and everybody saying everything's okay, might take longer than the open the next day on the stock market. So I think some of these pilot projects, like you said, in Australia, are designed to see what kind of lag there is from the time this thing is done until the books are deemed fair. I think that's the word they use, that everybody agrees and that the books are fair. But, of course, this technology doesn't extend just to that. It extends to real estate holdings, where we kind of get the government out of the business of who owns what. There would be some kind of public blockchain system for real estate holdings, and the government would back out of that business, and others like that.
Right.
But
right.
Just literally, there is a lot. If you have any other questions, please hang on.
No, I appreciate that, dude. Thanks so much.
If not, we'll go to some of the email already in my email basket. We'll look at MPLX when we come back.
David White has just announced a new online course that he'll be premiering to his subscribers the evening of July 26th, The Next Wild Wild West of Computing. Machine learning will be the biggest growth area for tech companies in the next 10 years. Make sure you're ready to capitalize on that opportunity. With over 50 types of algorithms and growing, Dave White will tell you why there are so many areas for companies to apply this to their business to both sell and consume. Right now, you can get a 30-day free trial to either of Dave's newsletters, Path of Least Resistance and The Technology Insider, as well as get a 30-day money-back guarantee when ordering Timing the Trade charts. Don't miss out on the next Wild Wild West of Computing as it premieres July 26th for all subscribers to Dave White Services. For all the details and to sign up today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Will the S&P 500 continue to climb? For bold trades on U.S. large cap stocks in either direction, trade SPXL, SPUU, or SPXS. Directions Daily S&P 500 Bull and Bear Leveraged ETFs. Direction Leveraged ETFs. An investor should carefully consider a fund's investment objective, risks, charges, and expenses before investing. A fund's prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a fund's prospectus and summary prospectus, call 866-476-7523 or visit directioninvestments.com. A fund's prospectus and summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And as we said, we were going to take a look. Warren in Denver wanted to look at MPLX. We'll take a look at that. Again, you can call me at 877-927-6648. Let's take a profile on it because it's been a while since I've looked at this. Want to make sure that I don't miss. Develops and acquires midstream energy infrastructure assets. It operates through logistics and storage and gathering and processing segments. Company engages in gathering process segments. So you've had a nice retracement, nice little bounce out here. This thing has kind of moved against the broad energy market. Energy has been strong to the upside, stronger to the upside so far. So it's moved nicely. The question is, he wants to buy it, and he thinks that somewhere around 28 to 31 would be the price that he wants to get it at. I think the answer is yes. I don't know enough of the inner workings. The first thing that scares me to death every time I look at one of these is that LP sign behind the ticker symbol. That means a limited partnership. I'm going to opine here just a little bit about limited partnerships. They are kind of the equivalent of the movie, the producers, or the play, which wherever you saw. I never saw the play. I saw both versions of the movie. One of Mel's better movies, but a very interesting movie if you've never seen it. Basically, some people are wanting some big cash. They act like big producers on Broadway. They decide to sell 1,000% or 2,000% or something like that of the movie. So they decide to make the worst movie ever in the world and go bankrupt, figuring that no one will ask for their money back. Of course, in their effort to make the worst movie ever, it's kind of a cult hit, and everybody's looking for a piece of that pie. So these LPs tend to be the worst for the investors and the best for the people that own the LPs. So to me, if you liked this sector, I would look elsewhere. You always find out that a lot of cash goes bye-bye, and it's kind of written into the bylaws of these LPs that, Tom say? Privatization of losses and, of course, public losses are taken care of and privatization of profits. And that's kind of the way that these things work. So I hate them to begin with, and I stay out of LPs at all possible risk. Just because any of the big side and upside, there just isn't a great deal there for you. And they will make sure that there are a lot of expenses that go into making sure that this thing is not a success. I'm going to say that maybe even a better model of these LPs are the music business or the publishing business, where there's all kinds of expenses that just kind of come out of thin air from the publisher or the and for both music and literary works. Fees for storing the books, fees for looking at the books, fees for trying to correct typos in the book, of which I've talked to several authors who said that they went in with 26 errors they knew of and came out with 56. And got charged $5,000 for the effort of adding more typos than they took out. So it ends up being one of these things where it may be a necessary evil, but is there any, maybe you give me a call, Warren, is there any other stock in the sector that you would like better that's a pure play, that is a that you get 100% of the reward of a higher price and more earnings? Instead of kind of getting the short end of the stick on that. So and maybe else someone else has an opinion on it. You can always call me at 877-927-6648. Reading the chart, you are correct. The downside is this thing had a big run from November 4th up to the February 16th. It came back on only a little less than two-thirds of the energy. It tested its previous low on half the volume. That was the buy, $30.88. I'm not so sure you're going to get a chance to get back into it at $31. That was a good buy. It went below the previous low did so on half the volume. It came back with less than two-thirds of the volume from the high, and there was your low. But two, you need to get in these LPs. You really need to know how they work underneath. They're kind of like a leveraged ETF. You've got to figure out what's going on, how they actually do it, and know when you can and can't be in these. But at best, the rules are written to overemphasize the owners of this LP, not you. So I'm just not a big fan of them. But maybe a call back in. We go to Wayne in Wayne's World in Dallas, Texas. It's whole like a whole other country. Hertz, HTZ. Well, the one thing I could think of since the parole of OJ yesterday is he's available again for ads. And I bet he's looking for a job. Hertz, could they do worse? I don't know. It's hard to think of. So we'll take a look at this one. It is up on a little juice. I kind of dislike that you didn't get a real good test of the lows out here. You had a move. But, man, when these things get beaten up this hard, that $8.56 low is still hanging out there. Long-term support is $8.65. So, to me, you know, it's doubled. You've got an opportunity, if it comes back on light volume, to buy somewhere in the middle of the candle from the 13th of July. That would probably be somewhere around the $13.50 or $14 level. That may be the first level of support. You got a good sign of strength, 24.4 million shares. The downside is you always have that $8.65 low from June 13th that could be tagged. I would hate to be long this thing in any kind of earnings cycle. It's had some huge down days when they've once again repeatedly disappointed. Even with all the trouble with Lyft and Uber, these guys are getting eaten up by those services, especially in the larger towns and cities where it's just so much easier to get an Uber. You can go out and drink. Don't have to worry about getting lost. And, of course, you got basically a chauffeur. And the cars are clean. You get to see the ratings of the people. Man, it's hard for me to see how Hertz and Alamo and all the rest do any better. And I'll think about this during the break.
Active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments? Then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC-insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you like it does me, visit everbank.com/TFNN to find out what they can do for you. Again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. Visit them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Well, we're off 3 points on the S&P cash volume. It's about 2 billion shares, which is a little better than I thought maybe we would have from yesterday. But I think they got most of the business done for expiration yesterday. Got a little bit of cleanup. Could we get down a few more points lower? The option market makers would like, but I'm kind of thinking that 2465 is probably about a low. We'll probably either bounce up and down on Monday. Good choice of which one it does. If it goes down on Monday, I'm assuming it goes up on Tuesday. And if it goes up on Monday, it goes down on Tuesday. So just look at that for options rollover. Then we get into Wednesday somewhere around noon where the market's going to start moving. We look on to fund buying from then on. Although fund buying has been rather tepid the last couple of months, it's always been kind of a little after the first week that we start getting a little juice in the market. But, you know, what can you say? Not a lot going on out here. Thought a little bit more about it, and you know, you had some nice juice in the last 4 or 5 days up here. If you wanted to take a stab at this, maybe the low mid-12s would be the level of support where you might be able to get in on this. And again, man, you just don't want to be long with this, I think, going into earnings. They've had so many downside surprises in the past, and I don't think that there's anything out there. But you know what? If you wanted to play this, and I think maybe there is a play in this, you might also look at options on this when you get back down there to at least limit your loss to maybe something like a buck and a half on it. So maybe you could hold through and even longer through earnings with maybe some out-of-the-money calls on this when it gets, if it gets back down to that low $12 range. It may be a better thing. As long as the VIX remains low, and we don't see a lot of juice out here, options continue to be a much better solution for many of these than anything else. So we'll keep an eye on that. Give me a call at 877-927-6648. Take a quick look at General Electric. Didn't think anybody was looking for any upside on General Electric. The only question was whether it was going to go down. Hit pretty hard, down on 74.5 million shares. And a kind of a quarter where they've thrown everything into it, including the kitchen sink. So you might actually have a hard time being short this thing in the next quarter. Certainly looked from the beginning of the books that they tried to make this the worst quarter possible, and hopefully the next quarter gets better. down. Decent volume today is 74 million shares against the last previous low on June 10th that had 47 million shares. If you go back and look at it a little bit farther, this continues to be problematic. They've got some new businesses coming along in the power generation business that should be big. And I mean big, big, big. They have a new turbine that's about 10% more efficient and could be billions of dollars worth of business for them in the next year or two. Just imagine not having to build a new power plant, but just put in a new gas turbine system that would put out 10% more power for the same amount of fuel. And you've got the reason why General Electric could be very good in that part of the business. You know, just been headed down for so long that the question is if anybody's willing to bet on them. And not a lot of people that I can think are out there. So that's kind of it for the moment. We'll take a look at some of the usual suspects we have out here. Want to look at the SMHs. This thing kind of got SMHs. We talked yesterday about how big a couple of these stocks that were coming out on earnings would be. So we'll talk about that. Wasn't surprised to see the SMHs down a little. Not a lot of juice so far, but SWKS, right? Skyworks Solutions. This thing was down to about 103 after the bell last night. It's not good. Wasn't bad. This thing's up to a high resistance, so it's going to be hard for it to break out. But the reason that this company's earnings were so interesting was, of course, the follow-on for the other companies that supply Apple with products and Apple itself. So if we can tell at least one day of what's going on with Skyworks Solution, now that we've gotten into the afternoon, it's about everything is mixed in. Let me put it that way. It's all in there. The idea that maybe they'll have a quarter that runs long, but other ones. Of course, Qualcomm, them and Apple continue to be in a food fight, and that came down on fairly hard volume. Not much follow-through today. 5105 is a low. We might actually see this one make some kind of significant bottom if it can get down to 5105. I suspect that their patent wall is going to hold and that Apple will eventually have to fold and say that, well, we really didn't mean all the horrible things we said about you. Qualcomm will go, okay, we're going to sell you our chip that has all the stuff that we patent, and we won't keep your iPhone out of the United States come Christmas, because that's the threat, and they've already talked about it. They've already filed paperwork for it. Question is, how fast are they going to push that? They want that to kind of meander through the system, not fast track it, but kind of meander through a lot of time before the iPhone ships, the new one ships. And, of course, it's going to use some technology that Qualcomm owns the patents to. And there is precedent for them getting out in front of this, letting Apple know that it could conceivably keep its products out of several countries, but no, most notably, the United States. Question in there, Apple could just buy Qualcomm. You know, they could, but again, I don't think they can, i.e., I think that the government wouldn't let them. That would be putting way too much power in a single smartphone company. I don't think that that would pass the smell test either at the Justice Department or in Congress. I think both of them would stand in the way of that. And if you didn't listen to the show maybe 3 weeks ago or 4 weeks ago, Qualcomm got in a big argument with Apple. Apple decided to publicly beat them up for better prices and basically throw a lot of shade their way, talk trash. We can talk about it a lot of different ways. Qualcomm pretty much had enough of it and said, okay, release the fact that they're going to be using another technology that's not quite as fast. In fact, it's about maybe only two-thirds as fast as Qualcomm's technology for the newer, faster LTE speeds. And that's been documented pretty much true as far as I can find out and reading people technically talking about it. So it continues to be an issue. So Qualcomm eventually, I think, gets its payday and gets its business back with Apple. The question is just whether or not that happens for the iPhones shipped this fall. I know Apple doesn't want to lose face, but could lose a lot of business for this ill-advised business venture.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White has just announced a new online course that he'll be premiering to his subscribers the evening of July 26th, The Next Wild Wild West of Computing. Machine learning will be the biggest growth area for tech companies in the next 10 years. Make sure you're ready to capitalize on that opportunity. With over 50 types of algorithms and growing, Dave White will tell you why there are so many areas for companies to apply this to their business to both sell and consume. Right now, you can get a 30-day free trial to either of Dave's newsletters, Path of Least Resistance and The Technology Insider, as well as get a 30-day money-back guarantee when ordering Timing the Trade charts. Don't miss out on the next Wild Wild West of Computing as it premieres July 26th for all subscribers to Dave White Services. For all the details and to sign up today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN. Also, a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And somebody had a good point, is that DOJ hasn't been involved in a while in one of these antitrust cases, but a lot of these buyouts have been, had the mighty kibosh put on them before they ever got there. There's been about 10. I could probably think of 10 off the top of my head if I wanted to use my top of my head for something else. And Congress has got in and put the kibosh on many of those. Even when the Obama administration wasn't doing anything. And, of course, Apple, we're only a couple of weeks. I think when they come back from the regular scheduled recess, we have hearings on whether Amazon should buy Whole Foods. So I think there's a lot more going on without actually ending up in court for a lot of these companies. So I wouldn't say that the Whole Foods thing is in, especially with Congress getting ready to showboat a bit on this subject and others. But I think we're going to probably start seeing the drumbeat a bit more about Amazon and its ability to literally copyright a name and destroy a business's value in half in one day, and whether or not they've made a monopoly level. You know, these things take a while. It took about 2 years for it to work its way to a head in the Microsoft 1999? I think it was 1999 when they came out with the ruling and Microsoft dropped in half. Or three quarters, dropped a quarter maybe the day. I'll have to go back and look at it. That's kind of been the last big one that happened intraday. They're smarter about doing it over the weekend now and that kind of stuff. But still is an issue. Let's take a quick look. I don't think Amazon's doing anything, much like the rest of the market already in progress. What else do we have out here? Somebody wants me to look at Tesla, which we'll do. Amazon made its high. It did so on lighter volume or equal volume, depending on how you want to look at it. It had 4 million shares on the 18th, 3 million shares on the 19th. Yesterday, you had 3 million shares. Today, you got 2 million shares. I don't see anything that says really short this thing right now. But again, if you wanted to be long this thing, why in the world would you be long the equity if you could buy the options and get rid of any of that potential overhang for maybe something happening and you losing a bunch of cash. You know, I'm wondering the way that Amazon acts is like they can't ever be broken up or had antitrust legislation against them. So I would say that maybe he's acting like he wants it broken up so he can take some of his cash out. There was a theory around Microsoft that Bill Gates wanted that same thing, break up the company so that he could get basically do IPOs on the operating system and the Office software suite side so that he could take a bunch of cash off fairly quickly. When it was finally settled, he just decided that he was going to sell shares for the next 15 or 18 years. And I think he still sells shares to some extent, but to a lesser extent in the last year. But he sold every week for 15 years. So it gives you a little idea. So anyway, you got Amazon at the highs here, not much happening. We'll be back with Tom O'Brien at 3:30. We'll be talking about all the different kinds of machine learning. That'll be at the bottom of next hour. So we'll look forward to his calls on what's going on in the market. See you at 3:30. And we'll see you next Monday. Same bat channel, same bat time. Remember to sell when you can, not when you have to.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletter.
You're watching Tiger TV.